The learning outcomes of the data warehousing chapter. Describe the basic definitions and concepts of data warehouses. Discuss data warehousing architectures. Describe the processes used in developing and managing data warehouses. Explain data warehousing operations. Explain the role of data warehouses in decision support. Explain data integration and the extraction, transformation, and load processes. Describe real-time data warehousing and describe data warehouse administration and security issues. First, let's start with a data warehouse. A data warehouse is the basic foundation of business intelligence. It is a pool of data for decision making. It is a repository of current and historical data. Next, we will look at the characteristics of a data warehouse. It is subject-oriented, integrated, time-variant, non-volatile, metadata, web-based, relational or multi-dimensional, client-server, real-time, write-time, and active. What is subject-oriented? Subject-oriented means that a data warehouse is organized by detailed subjects such as sales, products, or customers. Integrated means that data from different sources are placed in a consistent format, no naming conflicts, no discrepancies among units of measurement. Time variant means that historical data is stored, can detect trends, deviations, long-term relationships, also provide daily, weekly, and monthly views. Non-volatile means users cannot change or update the data. Web-based means that a data warehouse is accessible. Relational and multidimensional means that the data warehouse uses a relational or multidimensional structure. Client-server means that the data warehouse uses the client-server architecture to provide easy access to end users. Real-time means that the data warehouse provides real-time or active data access and analysis capabilities. Also, the data warehouse includes metadata. Metadata is data about data, about how the data are organized and how to effectively use them. Next, we will look at the types of data warehouses. There are three types: data mart, operational data stores, and enterprise data warehouses. Data marts are a subset of data warehouse, a scaled down version of a data warehouse. Fewer subject areas, fewer users. Operational data stores consolidates data from multiple systems and provides a near real-time integrated view of current data. The information is used for running the business on an ongoing basis and for short-term operational decisions, seldom more than a month or two old. Enterprise data warehouses are all-encompassing large-scale data warehouse that are used across the enterprise for decision making. It also requires the integration of data from many sources into a standard format. Next, we will discuss the data warehousing processes. Data warehousing is much broader in scope. This is the entire process of data extraction, transformation, and loading of data to the warehouse and the access of the data by end users and applications. Let's go over the data warehousing process overview. First, data is imported from internal and external sources. Internal sources can be the enterprise resource planning system or the legacy system, point of sale terminals, and other online transaction processing systems can be part of internal data sources. And then also data from external data sources can be imported. Next, the data is cleaned and organized consistently. Then the data is loaded into the enterprise data warehouse. Data marts are created as subsets of enterprise data warehouse, or data can be loaded into the data marts and then consolidated. The data marts can be consolidated into enterprise data warehouse. And finally, the analysis are performed using applications such as business reporting, data or text mining, online application processing, dashboard, web, and other custom built applications. Okay, so the major components of a data warehousing processes will be data sources, data extraction, data loading, the comprehensive database, metadata, and middleware tools. Data sources, as we have discussed, can be internal or external. Data extraction, commercial ETL software such as Oracle, SAS can be used for extracting data. For data loading, we use a staging area where data is transformed and cleaned, and then they are loaded into the enterprise data warehouse. The enterprise data warehouse is a comprehensive database that supports decision making. Metadata includes rules for organizing data, and middleware tools such as CoFusion enables access to the data warehouse from a variety of front-end applications. Next, we would be talking about the data warehouse architecture and the difference between two-tier and three-tier architecture. A two-tier architecture consists of two tiers. Tier 1 is the client workstation, and tier 2 is the application and the database server. So in tier 2 architecture, both the web server and the database server are in the same machine. Three-tier architecture, which is more robust, has three tiers. The client workstation is one, the web server or the application server is in one machine, and then the database or the data warehouse is separately stored in another machine. Okay, so the difference is that the application and the database server is in one in two tier, is in one machine in two tier, and is in two separate machines in three tier architecture. Next, we will go over the integration and the ETL process. The data integration covers three processes. Number one, accessing the data. Number two, combining different views of the data. And number three, capturing changes to the data. Next, we will talk about ETL, or extraction, transformation, and load process. ETL is the process through which data are loaded into the data warehouse. Extraction is selecting data from one or more sources and reading the selected data. Transformation is converting data from their original form to whatever form the data warehouse needs. This often involves cleansing of the data to remove as many errors as possible, and then loading, which is putting the converted data into the data warehouse. Next, we will, here you can see the process. The left hand side will show you the sources, and then you can see the extraction of the data, transformation of the data from the original form to whatever form the data warehouse needs by cleansing them and removing the errors, and then finally loading it into the data warehouse or to the data mart, or it can be from the data warehouse to the data mart. Next, we will be talking about data warehouse development approaches. There are two approaches. One is called the Inman model, which is called the top-down or the enterprise data warehousing approach, and the second one is called the Kimball model, which is the data mart approach, bottom-up. Okay, so in the first one, top-down Inman model, what we do is we first develop the enterprise data warehouse and then create data mart as subsets. In the Kimball model, we first create the data mart and then consolidate them back into an enterprise data warehouse. The next topic is real-time or active data warehouse. This type of data warehouse, they enable real-time data updates for real-time analysis and real-time decision making. And this type is growing rapidly, very rapidly. And these are the main topics in chapter 2. Other than this, we also have two more topics which I have covered separately. The OLTP versus OLAP, and you have a PowerPoint slide on the differences between those two techniques. And also another topic which is very important is dimensional modeling and star schema, and I have a separate video on that. And this covers our main topics from the data warehousing chapter. Thank you.